Hey guys, Christian here with River Pools, and in this video series, How Fiberglass Pools Are Made, we've talked about how the pool mold is constructed and what you should be looking for. We've talked about the beautiful blue gel coat finish and what makes it so durable. And then in the last video, we talked about gel coat blister protection. All three are definitely videos you want to go back and check out if you haven't done so already. Today, what we're going to do is we're going to start adding structure to your pool using polyester chop. But you know what? Standing in a studio isn't really showing you how it's made, so I want to do something a little bit different today. Let's drop the fake background and the microphone and, you know. Let's get out in the yard and in the shop and show you how these things are made in person. Sound good to you? Let's go. Okay, let's hop on the golf cart. And I want to talk about where polyester chop is used on your pool. Dang, forgot that. Got what we need.
By the end of this video, I want you to know three things. I want you to know what polyester chop is and how it's applied. I want you to know what other material options there are besides chopped fiberglass. And I want you to know what our standards are for the resin used to build your pool.
So this is our Del Sol 32 model. We're out here to show you the structure of your pool. So this is what I'm talking about right here. You see, in video one, we talked about the mold. Video two, we talked about the gel coat. Video three was the blister protection layer of vinyl ester resin. That's very important to know that. And you can't really see the vinyl ester resin layer because it's the same color of all the other resins. But then after that, we need to add structure to your pool. This is the structure I'm talking about. And we're looking for, in terms of the material we use, we're looking for a blend between strength and flexibility, and we're looking for uniform thickness throughout. See how even that is? Yeah, we're looking for uniform thickness throughout the ledges, throughout the walls, the floors. We want to make sure that we have a consistent product that's delivered to your backyard. So, what about the chopped fiberglass in particular? How's it applied? Let's head over into the shop and check all that out. Okay, we're in the shop now. Welcome to our home. This is where we build your pool. Polyester chop is short for See why we shortened it? It's the combination of three different materials applied simultaneously using
the chop gun.
What the heck kind of an accent was those three materials in no particular order are fiberglass strand roving that comes in a spool like this in a case like that from a company like that. Next up, polyester resin that comes in a barrel like this or that or that or that or that. You get the point. Here's what it looks like. It's not very pretty. Okay, the last ingredient, the last material is catalyst, and it comes in a jug like this and gets sent to the chop gun from a pump like that. So let me better explain how the chop gun works. The chop gun brings in the fiberglass strand roving across the top, and the cutter head chops it into short sections. Simultaneously, the catalyst and the polyester resin are mixed. All three materials are brought together in the air just before it hits your pool. At this point, the chopped fiberglass is rolled out to ensure that all of the fiberglass material has been saturated with the polyester resin. We also want to eliminate bubbles at this stage. More about that in just a second. Incidentally, the resin is what makes your pool shell hard, not the fiberglass material. You see, the fiberglass is simply the reinforcing agent for the resin, much like rebar is used to reinforce concrete.
Okay, so now you know how the chop gun works based on that little animation we just showed you. So now let's talk about the fiberglass material itself and the different options we have to choose from as manufacturers of fiberglass pools. The first is simple fiberglass mat roving, which is chopped fiberglass in a pre-assembled form in a very thin mat. We keep this on hand to build certain parts of our molds or jigs or anything we need to temporarily hold together, but this is not a good option to build a pool. It requires too many layers, too much time, blah. Remember, we're looking for strength and flexibility and uniform thickness throughout a layer. So the second best option would be woven fiberglass roving. Now, this is a really unique material because of its woven assembly. It's easy to apply. I mean, you could very well build a pool using this. However, we find that the end result is a bit too flexible in terms of a fiberglass pool. We don't want the pool to flex too much during transportation, lifting, and placing in your yard, because a pool that flexes too much could crack the gel coat. That is not good. So, the blend between strength and flexibility comes in chopped fiberglass. If you have a good fiberglass operator, a skilled fiberglass craftsman with years of experience using this stuff, he or she can place just the right amount of material exactly where it's needed. Some places we need to add a bit more structure, such as the rim of your pool, the bottom rim, or the ledges all the way around. Now, I mentioned a skilled fiberglass craftsman. If he or she moves too quickly using the chop gun, thin spots can result. And if he or she moves too slowly, well, then the material gets too heavy and can actually pull and sag, creating a thin spot up top and a thicker spot down below. And again, that thin spot is a weak spot in your laminate. Could we build a pool using woven roving? Yes, we could. But we prefer chopped fiberglass because we can place the material where we need it, and with skilled craftsmen, we have a nice even layer throughout your pool. That's not to say that woven doesn't have a place in your pool. Stay tuned to our next episode and I'll show you where this material is used. Last thing I want to go over, we talked about what polyester chop is and how it's applied. We talked about the various fiberglass material options we have to build out the structure of your pool. Lastly, I want to talk about our standards when it comes to the polyester resin used. Yes, we need to really pay attention to the materials used to build our pools. Listen, some manufacturers will actually add fillers to their resins. Now remember, I said that the resin is what creates the hard surface, the hard structure of your pool. The fiberglass simply reinforces that. So if manufacturers are putting fillers into their resin in an attempt to stretch the material and save money, then your pool isn't getting as much resin as it should. Your pool shell isn't going to reach its potential in strength. The other standard we have is that we don't want pigments in the resin used to build your pool. Some manufacturers will add coloring to it so that it has a pretty aesthetic appeal during transportation and delivery to your home. Quite honestly, we don't care that the outside of your pool looks resin brown. Ugh. We don't care about that because adding pigments to the resin makes it difficult to roll out air bubbles when we build your pool. You see, when resin and fiberglass are applied, air gets trapped inside that layer, and we need to use rollers to get rid of those air bubbles, to press them out and bring those two layers of lamination together. Well, if there's a pigment inside the resin, we can't see those bubbles, and if we can't see those bubbles, we can't roll them out. And if we can't roll them out, it cures like that, and that means there's a weak point in the laminate of your pool. No good. Thank you. Okay, so now you know what polyester chop is, the combination between polyester resin, catalyst, and chopped fiberglass. You know that polyester chop is applied using the chop gun. You know we use chopped fiberglass because it's the perfect blend between strength and flexibility. And you know that there should never, ever be any fillers and no pigments inside the resin used to build your pool.
Adding a pool to your backyard is a huge investment, and we at River Pools want to do all we can to teach you everything we know so that you can make an informed decision. I really hope this video was helpful for you. I certainly hope it was much more entertaining. Next time, we'll take a look at where woven roving and honeycomb when used in your pool to give it a bit more structure and help maintain its shape. I'm Christian with River Pools. We'll see you next time. Catch the wave.